गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल। सो एज वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड अवर चैप्टर नंबर 14 आर यूनिवर्स, सो टूडे वी विल डिस्कस और वी विल डू द एक्सरसाइज ई, दैट इज द शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, एंड दिस क्वेश्चंस आर गिवन एट पेज नंबर 126 इन योर बुक। सो इफ यू डोंट हैव द बुक, यू कैन सी द क्वेश्चंस इन द पीडीएफ व्हिच आई विल सेंड यू। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। क्वेश्चन नंबर वन इज, व्हाई इज लाइफ पॉसिबल ओनली ऑन द अर्थ। सो स्टूडेंट, इन दिस क्वेश्चन यू हैव टू राइट व्हाई द लाइफ इज पॉसिबल ओनली ऑन द अर्थ। सो एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट अर्थ इज अ यूनिक प्लैनेट एंड देयर इज अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ एयर, वाटर, सॉइल एंड द अप्रोप्रिएट अमाउंट ऑफ सनलाइट इज ऑल्सो रिसीव्ड बाय दिस प्लैनेट फ्रॉम द सन। सो दिस मेक द लाइफ पॉसिबल ऑन द अर्थ। सो लेट्स सी द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन वन। The presence of air, water and soil makes the life possible on the earth. So next question 2 is, why are Jupiter and Saturn known as gas giant? So student, in this question you have to write why the Jupiter and the Saturn are known as gas giant. So student, as we have discussed that after Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, they are the inner planets and their surface is rocky, so they are known as terrestrial planets. But after this, the Jupiter and the Saturn are the planet in which, or they are made up of gases like hydrogen and helium, and that's why they are known as gas planet, whereas they are very big in size, that's why they are known as gas giant planets, because they are big in size and they are made up of gases like hydrogen and helium. So let's see the answer of this question too. Jupiter and Saturn are known as gas giant because they are made up of gases. They are made up of gases and they are also very big in size. Next question 3 is, what do you understand by new moon? So in this question you have to define the new moon. So student, as we have discussed that moon is the natural satellite of the earth and moon do not have its own light, but we see the bright moon during the night time because it reflects the light of the sun that falls on its surface. And it is a natural satellite of the earth, so this moon also revolves around the earth on a fixed path, and that path is known as orbit. And generally student, what happened, we see only a part of the moon that receives the sunlight, and the part that receives the sunlight reflects the light, and from the earth we will able to see only that part. But during their revolution, during the revolution of the moon around the earth, there is a day when the part of the moon or the moon do not receive any light from the sun. So at that time we will not able to see the moon in the night sky, and we call that day as a new moon day, and in Hindi we call it as a amavasya. So let's see the answer of this question 3. When the side of the moon facing the earth does not receive any light or any sunlight and we cannot see moon, then it is called new moon. When the part of the moon that is facing the earth do not receive any sunlight, at that time we will not able to see the moon, and that day is known as new moon day. Next question 4 is, what are tides? How are they formed? So student, in this question first you have to define what are tides, lehre kya hoti hai, and how these tides are formed. So student, the rise and fall of the water of the ocean are known as tides, and they are formed due to the gravitational pull of the moon. Because the gravitational pull of the sun is also there, but the moon is at closer distance from the earth, so this gravitational pull of the moon affects the water that is present on the earth surface in the form of ocean. So the part of the earth that faces the moon, that region, the water that present in that region rises up. द एरिया दैट इज प्रेजेंट बिटवीन एंड इट क्रिएट्स अ हाई टाइड व्हेन द पार्ट ऑफ द अर्थ दैट फेसेस द मून दैट कॉज अ राइज इन द वॉटर ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर रीजन क्रिएट्स अ हाई टाइड एंड द रीजन बिटवीन द टू हाई टाइड्स क्रिएट्स अ लो टाइड. So this is formed due to the gravitational pull of the moon. So let's see the answer of this question. 4. The rise and fall of the water in the oceans are called tides and they are formed due to the gravitational pull of the moon. Next is question 5. What do you understand by waxing and waning? So student, in this question you have to write the difference between the waxing and the waning. So as we have discussed that there are different phases of the moon, the different shapes of the moon that we see in the night sky is known as phases and they are formed as a result of revolution of the moon around the sun. And they are formed as a revolution of moon around the earth, due to which what happened, only a part of the moon receives the sunlight and that particular part we will able to see from the earth surface. And as a result of this revolution, a day comes when there is a no moon or new moon day when there is no moon in the sky. And after the day passes, the illuminated part of the moon increases in size and that is known as waxing. And after this, when the time passes, a full moon day comes and again this full moon day or the full moon start to decrease in size and that is known as waning. So, the increase in the size of the illuminated part is known as waxing and the decrease in the size of the illuminated part is known as waning. So, let's see the answer. The increase in the size of the illuminated part of the moon is called waxing and the decrease in the size of the illuminated part of the moon is called waning. So, student, this is all about the answers of your exercise E. That's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.